bounces back with same speed. If its mass be 100 gram and hits the wall at right angles with 30 meter per second, calculate change in momentum. You have to calculate change in momentum.
Oh, but if both are same, then how can it be calculated?
Direction is important.
The direction has changed.
Remember, direction has changed. Direction has reversed. Momentum is a vector quantity. So direction makes... See, something like this. This is a wall. I've thrown an object. This is of 100 gram. Goes, strikes the wall with 30 meter per second. Bounces back with 30 meter per second. Question is, what is change in momentum?
So the velocity has changed, right? It would be minus 30 meter per second when it strikes back.
Yes. So initial velocity is plus 30 and final velocity is minus 30. So velocity has changed. The momentum has changed. The momentum has changed. So that's what I'm asking. Find change in momentum.
The answer is minus 6 kg meter per second.
Correct. Minus 6 kg meter per second.
Yes, sir. Minus 6 kg.
Let's write initial momentum.
Yes, sir. Minus 6 kg.
Correct. Initial momentum. Remember, this might be like one of your questions in 9th standard exams also. Okay. Because if collision concept is there in your book, it is there. I've seen it's in 9th standard. And if your teacher has taught it, so teacher will definitely ask a question from this. So you have to be careful. Direction is also important. That's why I have mentioned that statement. Momentum is a vector quantity and direction is also important. So direction is important. In velocity, we have studied. If anything is, any object is moving to right, so we say its velocity is positive. Whereas if it is moving towards left, so we say its velocity is negative. Right?
Negative.
So initial momentum is mass into velocity. Mass is 100 gram, convert into kgs, divide by 1000. Into velocity. So velocity is 30 to right. So I'll say plus 30. So answer is 3 kg meter per second. Now, final momentum. So final momentum again has mass into velocity. Mass is always positive. You don't have to put a sign on it. Velocity. Velocity, if object is moving to right, is positive. Then if object is moving to left, the velocity is negative. So if this was plus 30, now this is minus 30. So minus 30. Minus 3 kg meter per second. So what is change in momentum? Once again, change in momentum is final minus initial. So minus 6 kg meter per second. So change in momentum is minus 6 kg meter per second. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Next one. I'll draw a figure.
So
two spherical objects are there. Yeah, say.
I have to ask whether momentum can be zero.
Yes. If an object is at rest, then its velocity is zero. If an object is at rest, then its velocity is zero. So mass into velocity. Velocity is zero, therefore momentum is zero. Momentum of object at rest is zero. Okay.
Yes, okay.
So here I've drawn a figure, two masses, one is of 10 kg, one is of 5 kg. Both were approaching each other. This heavy one slows down after collision, becomes 10, and the one which was with lesser mass changes the direction of motion, bounces back. This is an hypothetical condition. I'm not saying this has to happen. I have created a hypothetical condition. This is a situation where two masses, one of 10 kg and 5 kg, were approaching each other, one with 15 meter per second, one with 5 meter per second, undergoes a collision. Masses are 10 kg. Masses are 10 kg and 5 kg, and velocities are, I'll draw another figure. Before collision, first object, 15 meter per second to right. And before this was moving to left with 5 meter per second. Now is it clear?
Yes, sir.
After collision, this continues with 10 meter per second in the same direction. And the second one moves in same direction with 5 meter per second. Masses are 10 kg, 5 kg. 10 kg, mass does not change. This is body 1, 2. This is object 1, 2. This is before collision. This is after collision. What you have to do is calculate change in momentum of both spheres. For first one, and then do the calculation for two. You have to find change in momentum for both of them. Change in momentum of first one and change in momentum of the second one. Both are how much?
So first
50. One is 15 meter per second.
50.
First is 50 kg meter. And second is? First is minus 50 and second is plus 50. First is minus 50 and second is plus 50. Let me show you the calculations for first.
I just said the second one. Yes, sir.
First momentum one is- before collision is 10 into 15. 150 kg meter per second. Momentum after collision. What is momentum after collision? Momentum after collision is 10 into 10. That is 100 kg meter per second. See? So what is change in momentum? Change in momentum. Change in
the second one is zero.
Yes. No. Again, you've made the same mistake. please take care of algebraic signs. Algebraic sign is important. Be careful while applying algebraic signs. Huh? So for first one, change in momentum is minus 50 kg meter per second. Okay. Now, what about second one? Second one, is it zero? Everybody is getting zero.
Meter per second. No, sir, 50 kg meter per second.
Correct. Correct. 50 kg meter per second. Okay. Okay. So, momentum after collision. Momentum after collision. How much it is? 5 into 5. 25. Momentum before collision. Before collision, what was direction of motion? Please mute your mic. 5 into 5, 25, but towards left. So I'll say minus 25. So what is change in momentum? Change in momentum is? Change in
minus 50 kilogram
momentum meter is second. Final nine plus na 50. Final minus initial. This is final. After wala is fine. So after is 25 minus 25 plus 20 plus 50. Remember one thing: be careful while applying algebraic signs. Towards right, I'm taking as positive. So whatever is measured towards left will be taken as negative. If an object moves to right, I'll say its velocity is positive. If an object moves to left, I'll say its velocity is negative. So for first body, before and after, both were towards right. So this is 150 and this is 100. Final minus initial is minus 50. For second body, 5 and 5. But first was towards left. So first is negative. Before is negative. Final is positive. So 25 minus 25. Okay. Clear na?
Yes, sir.
Now, let me write a statement. If you can consider it as a theorem or law or whatever, when two bodies are moving object, it's clear, dear.
No.
So if two moving change in momentum of both objects are equal in magnitude and opposite in sign. Remember it as a law. We have this in our syllabus, but written in different words, right? We call it law of conservation of momentum, right? So we have the same thing, but is given in different form. Here I have written in different form. If two objects collide, moving objects collide, then change in momentum of both objects are equal in magnitude and opposite in sign. So for now, consider it as a law, right? And use this law to do these calculations. Now, using this, solve this. There's an object of mass 10 kg. There's another object of mass 8 kg. Both moving to right. This is before collision, right? This was moving with 20 meter per second and this is moving with 5 meter per second. After collision, this moves with 16 meter per second. Calculate speed of the second one. Do it. Consider this as a law. If two moving objects collide, Then change in momentum of both objects are equal in magnitude and opposite in sign. Consider this as a law and solve this. Before collision, they were moving with 20 meter per second, 5 meter per second. After collision, this loses its speed, reduces to 16. What will be speed or direction of motion of the second one?
That is 16 or 6.
16. Before collision, it was 20 and 5. After collision, it is 16 and something. That something you have to determine.
So 16 and 4.
16 and
4.
4 is no, 4 is wrong answer.
It's 2 meter per second.
No. Anyone? Remember, this is an important question, huh? This is there in your book.
Sir, the second object direction is not given.
Second object earlier is moving with 8 kg meter per second. You have to find final velocity. Velocity after collision. See, these two objects collide. This is a heavy object coming with 20 meter per second, strikes with this. This one slows down. It appears that this has to speed up. So answer has to be something greater than 5. Now you have to estimate. No. How much?
Velocity is minus 5.
Minus 4.
No. Minus 5 means what? It has to move this way. How will it move this way? Our instinct tells us this was coming with 20. This was moving with 55. So it strikes this one,
nine.
Slows down. That means it has.
So 9.
Not 9. It's 10.
Nine.
Oh, yeah. No, 10. It's answer.
It's.
See, I'll tell you. It's 10. 10. Change in momentum of first object. What is change in momentum of the first object? Final momentum is?
So it's minus 40.
10
minus
into 40. 6.
Minus 40.
Correct. So 160 minus 200, that is minus 40. Now, let's calculate change in momentum of the second one. Change in momentum of second object. Second object, final velocity is V. I don't know how much it is. 8 into V minus 8 into 5. 8V minus 40. Now, this and this are equal, but opposite in sign. So whatever is this, it has to be minus of this. So it has to be minus of minus 40. So 8V minus 40 is equal to plus 40. So 8V is equal to 80. V is equal to 10 meter per second. So the first one moves with 16 meter per second in same direction. Second one will move with 10 meter per second in same direction. Just see if it is clear, then okay. Otherwise, I'll explain again. Tell me, shall I explain again?
How is it equal to the momentum of the first object?
That's what I said, na? I have written a statement here and I said, treat it as a law. This is there in your syllabus. If you've already studied this chapter, you might have read it in the form of law of conservation of momentum. Change in momentum of the two objects when they undergo a collision is same in magnitude, but opposite in nature. We say if one of them has gained, the other has lost, something like that. So if change in momentum of first is minus 40, for other it has to be plus 40. But I got it as 8V minus 40. So 8V minus 40 should be equal to plus 40. Got the answer? V is equal to 10. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
I hope samajh mein nahi aaya to please puchna. I'll explain again and again.
Yes, sir. I understood.
I won't mind explaining again.
Okay.
Arna has not said anything yet. Arna?
Yes, sir.
Sachit?
Yes, Arna, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let me give you one more example. One more question. Last of this type. This is an important question, huh? Two objects. First one is of 10 kg, other is of 20 kg. First one is moving with 8 meter per second towards right, second one is at rest. They undergo a collision. Find the velocity of the first one. If second one after collision moves with 5 meter per second to right.
So negative 20.
Negative 20. Not 20. How much is it? Negative 2, na? 80. And here it is 100. So 100 it has to be. So minus 2. So minus 2 is the correct answer.
Yes, sir. Minus 2.
Change in moment. Change in momentum of first object. Final momentum is, let us assume, 10V. Initial momentum is 10 into 8, 80. Now change in momentum of the second object. What is change in the momentum of second object? Second object, 20 into 500, initial was 0. Therefore, 10V minus 80 is equal to minus 100. They should be equal in magnitude but opposite in sign. If this is 100, this has to be minus 100. So 10V minus 80 is minus 100. So if 10V minus 80 is minus 100, what is 10V? 10V
negative 2
is minus 20. So V is minus 2 meters. So velocity at the end of So the velocity after the collision is minus 2 meters per second. Okay. So I'll stop here. Okay. If you have doubt in this topic, we'll discuss tomorrow. Otherwise, I'll proceed. Okay. And I'll send you a worksheet after the class in group. Please attempt it. And if you have doubt, ask me tomorrow.